Welcome to TTI. Today we are listing some of the world's most amazing transportation stories that are so large scale they might make you feel like Superman was orchestrating it all. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this video, my friend.
Number 1.
Bagger 288. The Bagger 288 is a mining machine and bucket wheel excavator. It's the biggest machine designed to work in open pit coal mines. It's got a height of 330 feet and the length of almost 2 football fields. It's so huge it requires 5 drivers to handle it. In 2001, this excavator completed work at one mine and moved on up to another 14 miles away. Turns out it was cheaper to move it in one piece than to dismantle it and put it back together after transportation. But it's no smooth task. The travel took over 33 weeks. The vehicle had to cross over a river, a highway, a railway, and a few roads at a speed of 33 feet per minute. The trip cost almost 50 million Deutschmark and required a group of 70 workers. The Bagger's transportation was made possible thanks to 12 systems on the track chain with electric drive, 7 million cubic feet of mud and gravel to level out the roads. In some places, even grass sod had to be laid down to allow the load to pass.
The speed of these machines are up to perhaps maybe about 30 feet per minute, which would translate into about 1/3 of a mile per hour.
However, the fact that they can move at all is a technological miracle brought about through the use of giant crawlers.
Number 2.
Nuclear reactor. A Saudi company has transported a 1,048-ton reactor 683 miles over steep desert hills and narrow winding roads. It was carried on a hydraulic trailer. Going up each hill was a difficult task. Some would even fall behind, switching to 2 trucks in the back and 4 in the front. Trucks and trailers were connected to each other mechanically, which increased the traction and braking capacity. Engineers hope in the near future transporting loads over 2,000 tons will be made possible with just a single truck in front and behind of the cargo. A company called MAMMOET’S began developing new heavy transport machinery called Trailer Helper. It uses tugs with hydraulic drive to reduce the need for multiple trucks presently required for traction, direction, and towing capacity. With the help of this trailer, the speed will increase to at least 5 times, and as a bonus, it requires only 1 driver to manage the whole system, which practically excludes mistakes in coordination.
Number 3.
Eni Norge Oil Rig. The Eni Norge Oil Rig in Norway contains the largest floating oil drill in the world. It needed the help of the Dockwise Vanguard for transportation. This historically named Dutch ship was made for heavy jobs like this one due to its size, strength, and submersible capabilities. It has the power to carry 220 million pounds and has made easy work of moving the 351-foot diameter oil rig, which has the ability to fill 100,000 barrels a day. The oil rig is no doubt made heavier by its construction, as the particular oil rig is headquartered in Norway. In early 2015, the Vanguard made its voyage westward to the Eni Norge construction site in South Korea, through the Indian Ocean under the southern tip of Africa, followed by a 60-day journey to Europe. Once docked to its mining station, the Eni Norge was connected to its mainland power source.
Number 4.
Harriet Gas Turbine. The machine's official name is the 9HA, and it's made of heavy parts originally fabricated for jet engines. The efficiency of this turbine is nearly unmatched, which is why the precious cargo was treated to a long, slow drive through the country at an average speed of 10 miles per hour. The device was held suspended by a long metal cradle, which was connected to hinges by flatbeds on either end. This allowed the lengthy trailer to take its turn slow and with ease to ensure a successful commute. Engineers needed to examine every turn along the route between Belfort and its final location in Strasbourg, capping off 3 years of in-depth planning.
Number 5.
Large Binocular Telescope. For a viewing device that peers out into deep space, the world's largest mirror telescope needed to take a very earthbound road trip before taking its seat on the mountaintop where it is today. Now glimmering on top of Emerald Peak in Arizona, the telescope's 30-foot-long mirror required nearly a half a year of planning and a week of travel to get to the top of the 10,480-foot peak. The voyage began on October 23, 2003, and the 35,000-pound load left the mirror lab and headed to the base of the summit, traveling a total of 122 miles at a speed of 45 miles per hour. The following 6 days were spent prepping for the trip to the tip of the mountain. On 24 axles, the flatbed traveled upward, winding from ridge to ridge at a single mile per hour, with the mirror suspended upright over the carefully inspected and smoothed out road. The task was repeated soon after for the telescope's second mirror, which was needed to make it function like a set of binoculars, hence the name Large Binocular Telescope. Its worthwhile journey to the top of Emerald Peak allows us to get a closer look at the stars.
Number 6.
Muon G2 Magnet. Muon G2 is a large accelerator owned by a company called Fermilab. It's made to analyze muon, tiny, short-lived, highly magnetic particles. These muon experiments are intended to measure the exact timeline of a muon particle's existence and test whether they adhere to the laws of modern quantum physics. Muon are considered heavy electrons, and their analysis could be used to study how substances react to each other at the atomic level. Obviously, these particles aren't as heavy as the accelerator used to study them. The G2 required a small army of vehicles and technicians to move it from its construction site in Long Island to its home at Fermilab in Illinois. At 50 feet in diameter and with a 90,000-pound apparatus intended to keep the device level and protected, the 3,400-mile journey to move this electromagnet took more than a month to complete. After a two-day drive through Long Island, New York, the accelerator was moved by crane to a bridge, which sailed south along the East Coast, around Florida and up the Mississippi River until it was transferred to another truck and driven for three straight days to Fermilab, finally finishing out its big move.
Number 7.
MAMMOET’S Heavy Offshore Haul. MAMMOET is a Dutch company specializing in the movement and transportation of incredibly heavy objects. Based on their track record, we're sure they could carry an entire parade on top of their flatbeds. MAMMOET towed the heaviest offshore module to ever be dragged on land. At 279 feet long, 100 feet high, and 700,000 pounds, this job garnered them a spot in the Guinness Book of World Records. Originating in Newcastle, UK, the BP Clare topside module required a year of engineering and development prior to the move. 470 axles were needed for the gigantic flatbed, tasked with carrying it topside, with modules broken down and arranged in a Tetris-like fashion to fit accordingly on the vehicle. The flatbeds were all linked physically and technologically with a computerized system monitoring structural integrity for SPMT, or self-propelled modular transporters. A ballast system and a team of forklifts were coordinated and choreographed to help hoist BP's machinery from the flatbed to a customized barge that would take this puppy out to sea. Once the SPMT takes the module onto the module is then jacked up high enough for the SPMTs to be removed, and then it's welded to the barge before being sent out to sea. We hope you like this video. Which transportation story did you find to be the most interesting or cool? Let us know in the comments, and subscribe for new thinking. See you in the next video. Peace.